miles south of Portland is a snapshot of America.
Enjoy your visit.
Silverton, Oregon, population 9,500. Farming's big, half Democrat, half Republican.
They've all known me for years.
A downtown theater, coffee shops. It's a town where everybody knows your name.
Good afternoon, Stu.
Good afternoon.
And its mayor.
I seem to be a lightning rod for attention.
How are you?
I am fine.
And love the leggings. I want to steal them.
Stu Rasmussen is the first transgender mayor in America. Been reelected three times.
It's good to have vivacious people around.
He's every bit a man except for the breast implants.
I like having cleavage. Some of the women in town are jealous of my legs. That's always the subject of conversation around here too. You know, what's Stu wearing today?
There you go, Stu.
Office hours.
Thank you, Greg.
Means sitting outside the Silver Creek Coffee House with the usual.
Asiago cheese bagel with cream cheese, cup of coffee.
I am delighted to meet you.
He's a really awesome, nice guy, and he's very smart.
How have you been?
Good. It's a little different, but that's okay, you know, because people enjoy him, and they really appreciate the job he does for the town. That's why he's been reelected for the third time.
Born and raised here, huh?
All my life so far.
Stu's story is more than his appearance. Once a projectionist, he now runs Silverton's movie theater. It was one movie in particular that changed his life.
He was a sweet transvestite from transsexual Transylvania. Oh my.
In the cult classic Rocky Horror Picture Show, the lead character is a man dressed in women's lingerie.
That was probably a pivotal moment for me to see the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
How'd you do? Since he was a kid, Stu felt he was more woman than man. The movie inspired him to make it public.
Every little boy growing up was fascinated by breasts. I was so fascinated by them that I wanted a set of my own.
But his change wasn't without challenges.
There is no hope for this place.
In 2008, members of the radical Westboro Baptist Church from Kansas, the fundamentalist group known for picketing funerals of soldiers killed in battle, well, they showed up in Silverton.
If there's nobody in this entire place that's going to stand up and say, that's a pervert, somebody needs to say it, and we're going to say it.
But the town came together and rallied around Stu.
Honestly, I am overwhelmed by the community's response that this is absolutely the best town on the planet.
There were a couple of hundred Silverton people saying, get out of town. You know, we don't need you, we don't want you. I mean, it's 5.5, 6 years, and it's still an emotional issue for me that the town is that way.
Stu's story spread, a story about being yourself and not letting your surroundings change that. Then 3 years ago, Stu got a phone call from director Andrew Russell.
And I said, hey, has anyone come to you to make this into a musical or a piece of theater?
nah, never happened. I'll win the lottery first.
But it did happen.
Yes, I feel like I'm alive for the first time at the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Russell loved Stu's story. Being a gay man, he felt he had to leave the small town he grew up in to be himself.
The idea that Stu would just simply stay put.
Call me Stu.
And trust that a town would change around him and embrace Stu for whatever and whoever Stu is was just beautiful and is what theater's about.
I have legs that could stop traffic, but my face could stop a clock.
Stu for Silverton, the musical, was born.
Never on my radar, you know, when I was growing up on my bucket list that there would be a musical with me as a character in it.
In Seattle, Matt Markovich, Como 4 News.